Hey guys, it's John Murray. I fish professionally for a living, but I recently moved to Tennessee to just to experience ledge fishing on the famed reservoirs of the TVA reservoirs. The one thing that I've learned about ledge fishing is that there's no right or wrong way to do it. And basically what ledge fishing entails is miles and miles of similar contoured ledge dropping off in a river channel, and you're keying to find those tight spots based on current or maybe shell beds or maybe a break that those fish will gang up on. So really the key to ledge fishing is obviously good electronics. You want to be able to cover the water efficiently with electronics, but sometimes even with great electronics, those fish get tight or they sit tight to the break, you don't see them. So you do have to fish. And one of my new favorite ways to fish that way is with a biffle bug or a hardhead. And basically you can use any sort of bait with it. You know, it was made for a crawdad type bait like the biffle bug, but you can actually use a swim bait style. You can use a big worm. I use an 8-inch yellowtail a lot. And basically the beauty of this is it fishes as fast as a bait, but it works that water column on the bottom that you're going to be working with jigs and worms. So when I'm using a hardhead for a ledge fishing, I'm making long casts. I'm covering that water column and it's hitting and I'm reeling. And I'm just keeping that bait bouncing off the bottom like a crankbait, but it's faster because I can fish it in 25 feet of water, 5 feet of water, 30 feet of water. It's always in the strike zone. So the hard head or the biffle bug, however you want to describe it, I throw it on a 7.5-foot rod. I'll throw 16-pound gamma fluorocarbon line, and I want a reel that reels fast because I want to be able to catch up to them if they eat it. So I'll use a high-speed loose reel, make as long a cast as I can, get it on the bottom, and just start pounding the bottom with it. And when you get a bite on a ledge, whether it's 12-incher or a 12-pounder, I always hit a waypoint and try to understand why that fish was there, because usually there's miles and miles of similar cover, and there's one spot or two spots where they're all ganged up. So that's the key. Cover that water, find those active fish, and get a bait like that that you can cover that water effectively and catch those fish. But ledge fishing, it's one of my favorite ways to fish and one of the reasons I moved to Tennessee. And I'm learning a lot about it, and I think that some of the best parts of it is covering water and paying attention to when you catch those fish.